We're gonna go over whether or not you should incorporate your business. Let's do this. How's it going? My name is John and I am a mortgage broker located in Vancouver. If you wanna learn ways to be approved for a mortgage, home buying tips, and other mortgage related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking on the notification bell so you won't miss anything. I'm here today with Hayson Chan, accountant at Truspect Consulting. Thank you so much for joining us, Hayson.
Thank you, John. Happy to be here.
Yeah, Hayson's specialties is to strategize and structure a plan to pay as little tax as possible. So Hayson, one common question that I usually get from my clients is whether or not they should incorporate.
Yeah, we get this question a lot actually. So one of the advantage to incorporate is to limit the liability. Many times when a business owner decide to incorporate their business, it is actually a separate entity. It has nothing to do with them actually. And a lot of people, they don't get this. When it comes to dealing with creditors, in case if you go bankrupt, so the creditor cannot go after your personal assets. So safeguarding your personal assets is actually one big advantage for business owner.
How far does this limited liability go? Like, what about like realtors or doctors? Would they be protected as well?
No, the bad news is for professional people like you and I and like doctors and dentists. If your patient, you know, if you do something to your patient and he or she pass away, you cannot escape because the professional, you know, association will go after you. Because as a professional, you cannot incorporate a John Lee medical professional. And if you screw up and if nothing happened to you, no, like something is going to happen to you, actually. And when it comes to borrowing money from a bank, many times creditors or bankers would, you know, request for personal guarantee, which is directed guarantee, which is yourself. Yeah. So they can put a lien on your house, you know, or else they won't give the money to your company. So it depends on the situation.
And what other benefits would there be?
So the second advantage would be the ability to raise capital. There are so many stages in business actually. So this startup, like when people are good at what they're doing and they thought about, I don't want to work for someone else, I want to work for myself. So they become a sole proprietor, right? So when the revenue increased to a certain level, they decide to incorporate. To some level in the business, they decide to expand the operation. So, and they need more money, like financial support and also, you know, resources like, you know, connections to, you know, different suppliers and customers, right? So if you have a corporation, then actually you have the ability to raise capital by selling shares of your company. And hopefully you, the investor of the company can also, give you the connections, so it helps you to grow your business. And eventually, hopefully, you'll be able to pay some dividends to the people in believe in your business.
Well, it's interesting you mentioned about paying dividends out. There are some corporations that I know, they would pay themselves as an employee, and some they will pay themselves as dividends. What seems to be the better option?
Salary versus dividends, right?
Yeah.
That's actually a tax planning question. So it depends on the personal income tax, how much money that they are, you know, receiving from the corporation. So in short, for salary, is tax deductible of the company. So the salary that you pay to yourself as a business owner is tax deductible. So your corporation actually pay less tax. When it comes to salary, you have to pay CPP, EI, and also you can create a room for RRSP deduction, a contribution room, okay? But when it comes to paying dividends, actually the corporation has to pay taxes first, and the remaining money to pay yourself, we call that dividends. And dividends, you know, are not tax deductible. In terms of paying how much salary versus dividend, actually it's a tax planning question. It really depends on your personal income tax.
So is there a benefit to not pay and just leave it in the company?
It depends on your personal lifestyle. So if you need to use the money, a lot of the time when people start a business, so they actually inject a lot of capital inside the corporation. So that creates a room for a shareholder loan. It means that your son or daughter slash your corporation owe you a lot of money. So if you take the money out as a shareholder loan repayment, it's actually tax-free.
So then, at what point, so say if someone is a sole proprietor, at what point should they come to you and consider incorporating?
I would say approximately 65,000-75,000 of income, then it probably worthwhile to look at, you know, setting up a corporation. so for tax planning purposes.
And once the corporation is set up, what other things or fees would they need to think about now that this is a new entity?
Right. A lot of people, they want to set up the corporation themselves. I don't recommend that, because what happens is when they set up the corporation, you have to issue different share structures, and you know, it's something that lawyers would help you to do. If you did not set it up correctly, you know, afterwards, you know, if you have to, issue dividends to yourself, and it's really tough when the lawyers say, you know, this is set up wrong, so I have to do it again. Actually, it's going to cost business owner more money. So in terms of like accounting fees, it has to be making sense, right? Because it means that if you make more money, the more taxes that you save. So the professional fees is actually doesn't cost you a lot.
And what else would you offer as advice for those who are considering incorporating?
I would say review your financials and also talk to your accountant and see how much money that you're making, how much money you're spending. So business owner work really hard to have a good lifestyle. So make sure that your money is work as smart and as hard as you.
Well, thank you again, Hayson, for joining us today. So how would someone be able to get in touch with you if they have other questions in regards to incorporating?
Yeah, they can phone us or email us. The contact information is in the description area. Thank you for having me, John.
And there you go. We just went over whether or not you should incorporate your business. And please remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel to learn more. And make sure you click on the notification bell so you won't miss a video. I'm John Lee, mortgage broker and CEO of Arise Mortgage. We're always achieving your approval.